What's up, guys? Augmented here, playing some more WWE 2K15 Universe Mode. We're on week 4 of NXT. We just came off of an awesome pay-per-view on ECW, presenting Extreme Rules. Besides a few matches being a little weird, good night overall. I know the main event was long, sorry for that. But either way, we're still kicking on with NXT. Corey Graves takes on Justin Gabriel in our first match. Summer Rae takes on Tamina in our second match. Third match features Adrian Neville versus Tyson Kidd, a rematch. This time, no Natalya with Tyson Kidd. So hopefully this match can go on a lot better than the last NXT match. Scott Mercury, Kofi Kingston, and Psychosis take each other on in an Extreme Rules Triple Threat match. The rivalry matches start here tonight, with Natalya versus Brie Bella. Our second rivalry match, Rey Mysterio takes on Bad News Barrett. Our third match, and rivalry match that I really wanted to see, and I put together myself, was Sami Zayn versus Daniel Bryan. And I hope these two do not disappoint, and that is our main event of the night. But let's get started with our first match of the night, Corey Graves versus Justin Gabriel. Let's get started. Alright, it's been a while since I played a first match, like, of the night. So, let's get with it.
And King, what do you think of this pairing?
We're starting off strong, Michael. And things are just gonna keep getting better.
Ooh.
I think Gabriel's wings have been clipped in this one.
So, if anyone didn't know, I talked about this, like, first to second week that, Corey Graves was in my universe, that he can't wrestle anymore. I don't know if it's a real thing. I don't know if it's a thing they do for wrestling. It was like, okay, he just needs to take time off. Even though he's there for NXT, you know, he's not there in the ring. So he could be a trainer now. Who knows? He has worlds tons of experience. So who knows what the hell he's up to? But I'm glad to know that he's still doing things. I think he should be an action movie star, to tell you the truth. He has an action movie star face and everything like that. Definitely could work it out. He has a voice for it. He doesn't sound like a little girl or anything like that. He's very,
and he gets back in.
He just has all the tools for it. Not exactly the tallest guy in the world, but I mean, an action movie star doesn't always have to be tall. But also, recently, Justin Gabriel was released from WWE. So, sad to see him go, even though they weren't using him. And you kind of saw it coming. You know, they try to build him up so much. They really did try. It just did not work out for him, so hopefully to see him maybe possibly in Ring of Honor, who knows? You could see him maybe in AAA, something like that, some indie federation, because he's a good wrestler. His family is his family, but I think he's a second generation superstar. So it sucks you want to have your goals be wrestling, but you can't do it because, you know, WWE doesn't want to pay you or whatever, or not pay you, WWE doesn't want to use you, so whenever they feel fit to use you, they can just, you know, say, oh, we want you here, or we don't want you here, or maybe he didn't want to do it himself, so I don't know, but either way, it's good to know these guys are still alive, still kicking, so anything can happen in the future.
There he goes.
Oof. I'm bringing it to Gabriel right now, I don't care, you know what I'm saying, I really don't care. Let's do this show, so. I think his moves are running knee thing.
Corey Graves is,
oh, shit! That was, ladies and gentlemen, that was not a spear. That was me going for the legs, but that's the reversal that they have, which is amazing.
Back in the ring.
I did that earlier in a match before Universe, and I was like, holy shit, that's the reversal for that? Like, it looks so cool. Now Gabriel has a fucking signature, and he could turn the fucking whole tables on my ass and beat me in the match here. But yeah, I'm loving that these rivalry matches are happening now. I wanted them to happen a little earlier, but it's whatever. Also, oh, let me get this guy down first. Here we go. What I should have done before I started my universe, and I keep regretting it to myself, I'm willing to tell you guys, is I should have simulated the first 2 years of WWE, just the universe, so I can get all the stories. And when the rivalries come up, I can pick whatever rivalries I want, you know? I don't have no stamina. So, another mistake by myself. What a shot. Oh, going for that leg bar.
Tap out, son.
Tap out! Oh, got his legs yellow.
Things are going through that mind right now. When you get in control like this, you want to
throw
everything at your opponent. That could be what we're seeing here. Wow, what a drop kick.
Shit. Oh, what? Fucking ass. That's bullshit. He was running clear at me. You can't fucking stop middle of the thing. That's whack. Here we go.
Get ready, folks. Get ready.
What you doing? What you doing, Graves? What you doing? Oh, leg breaker. Got him. More like a knee breaker, but let's end this before it starts getting weird. Oh, man. Wow, he didn't even get finished the animation yet, and fucking Graves is on his ass. No! The Lucky 13! Come on! Come on, Lucky 13! Lucky 13! Come on! Come on! Rip your fucking legs off, man! I really did try. I even hurt my voice doing that shit.
I'm scared to ask.
You shithead. But yeah. Anyway. Sucks seeing good wrestlers go, because Justin Gabriel Duffin was a good wrestler. It just wasn't the time for him. And who knows? He could return in the future. I didn't really read the article. I just knew that he was released. So he could also left on his own. But then they say, "Oh well, yeah, we released him." Like, yeah, you fucking assholes. Sure, released him. So, who knows? Oh, I love that move, but it sold so weirdly. By the time I get him dragged to the middle, he's going to kick out. I mean, he's going to get up. Oh, or not. Oh, or yes, he did. Oh! He kicked him clear in the head. Corey Graves going for it.
I don't know how he can counter this. You're not getting out of it.
You're not. It was a damn squash match, pretty much. I mean, Gabriel had a couple moves in there, but
Corey Graves wins.
Yeah.
Let's go to the highlights here.
So, I don't know about Corey Graves. I love Corey Graves, but his finisher, I feel like it needs to be something else. I love the Lucky 13, but I think both of his finishers are Lucky 13s, and he needs a move that gets shit done quick. Because I'm not gonna go after some guy's leg a whole fucking match. I don't go after limbs, not in this game, because it's not like it does anything. It's not like the older games where if you went after someone's leg, you see them limping around, or when they run after you, they kind of trip over or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, that's how you would get out of the fucking online fuckers who always want to run around in the circle and shit. You would break their fucking legs up, and they would trip over and hurt themselves.
Here's your winner,
but
Corey Graves.
I don't know.
Now let's be honest. This one wasn't even close.
Yeah, this is a squash match of the match.
Far from an even match as you can get.
This is a squash match to the fucking maximum, dude. But yeah. Maybe in the future. 2016 has promise. We'll find out then. Anyway, the next match, Summer Rae takes on Tamina. Only on NXT. I wanted to see this match play out, so let's see what they got.
Oh boy, Cole. She means business, that's for sure.
Tamina's still your number one contender for the NXT Women's Championship, currently held by Natalya. But I didn't want to play as Tamina because I know the match would have been too easy if I just had her versus Summer. And I was like, yep. Or like me playing as Tamina. It could have been too easy. I would just have a couple super kicks and it would have been over. But now, let's see if Summer Rae can step her game up. She is number four contender for the NXT Women's Championship. But if she can beat Tamina here tonight, that might put her a lot closer than you think. But right now, Tamina is definitely your number one contender for the championship. So let's see what goes on in this match. That was a nice DDT. I'm surprised Summer is not getting squashed right now. Seriously, like, her momentum has to be on Tamina's side. Tamina hasn't even lost a match yet. Yeah, she hasn't lost a match. So,
Did you see the neck snap back?
This kick to the back there. So in other news, while this match is going on, playing some Warframe recently on the PS4. Really like it a lot. It's like parkour and guns and fucking swords all at the same time. It's fucking amazing. I almost like it as much as I like Destiny. I'm not gonna lie. And I'm a pretty big Destiny fan. I mean, I'm not playing it every day like I used to. But I'm liking it a lot more than Destiny at this point. And it's free to play, mind you. So get that in the back of your head too. So if anyone hasn't played Warframe, you can get it on the Xbox One, you can get it on PS4, you can get it on PC. You can get damn near anywhere besides Xbox 360 and PS3. But yeah, you can get it on all two current gen, next gen consoles, and you can get it on PC as well. Fucking, that game is so damn cool. So damn cool. There's so many missions, and I've only gotten like a little bit through it. But oh, look at this. Fucking huge toss by Tamina there. Some Ray showing that she has a little more speed than Tamina, or Tamina using more strength than Summer Rae. Jeez. Holy crap. Oh, going for those Mongolian chops. And Summer Rae showing off that fucking A. What is that? Snapmare. Sorry. I don't know what the Snapmare is. The Snapmare. Yeah. Like a Snapmare arm drag. Oh shit, what the fuck? Out of nowhere. Splits. She got the splits on her. That's enough. Is it enough to take out Tamina here? 2-2. Anyway, yeah, Destiny at Warframe's a shit. Get it if you can. Get it if you can, definitely. It's an experience for anyone. You don't have to be a guy or a girl to play this game. It's really just cool for any person. I don't know if that was Summer Rae's finisher or not. I have not paid attention to changing her moves or not, but either way, Tamina's gonna have to put some work in a minute, because this might get out of hand. I mean, anything can happen, but if he can defeat her tonight, that might take her out of the whole title picture here. Then again, Tamina's been undefeated for damn near 3 weeks or so far, so who knows what we'll see.
Look at this.
1, 2, 3. That was even her finisher. That's how fucking crazy Tamina's killing it. Wow, that face was weird. I thought she had her with that one, because I wasn't sure if it was her finisher or her signature or not, but come to find, I don't think it was. Jeez. Tamina's killing it with or without me. I love it. Love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. How many times are you gonna see this shit without, like, I want to see championship on her fucking waist by the end of the month. End of the month, I want to see it.
Domination is what that was. My goodness.
But it all depends what happens in the future. We'll find out. Anyway, up next, Adrian Neville takes on Tyson Kidd, only on NXT. Big time rematch. Let's get to it. It's another match I kind of wanted to see play out, because last time it didn't happen. It was getting good, and I was really into it. I hope you guys were watching as well. I hope you guys are watching that just enjoyed the fucking match. And it was getting really good, and then Tyson fucking hits his own girl. Oh my gosh. And it was like DQ. I was like, are you serious? And it's like, you know, having divas in your corner is never too bad of a thing. But once your diva gets hit, it's like automatic disqualification. You're like, oh my gosh, are you kidding me? So, who knows? If you guys haven't seen Adrian Neville versus Tyson Kidd in real life, Holy shit. They had a match yesterday? Well, I mean, whatever. Well, I mean, 2 days ago in my time. But Wednesday, they had a good match for the number. They had a tournament trying to find out who the next number one contender is going to be. And, I mean, Neville won, but man, it was an awesome fucking match. Then they had a match a while back when NXT was just starting up on not just starting up, but starting up on WWE Network when they had the NXT Arrival. Holy shit, that match went on so long, but it was so good. It was really good. I mean, these two can damn near go blow for blow everything. Like, they both fly. They both fucking technical wrestlers, both great ground game wrestlers. It was so cool to see these two fucking go at it. I was like, holy shit! I didn't know Tyson Kidd was like could move so fast. I mean, I thought Adrian Neville at the time was the fastest fucking thing in wrestling. I didn't know Tyson Kidd could compete with him like that. Like, I know Tyson Kidd's a very technical wrestler. I know he's a very good high flyer. I didn't know he could keep up Adrian Neville like that. He kept up. There was times where I was like, holy shit, Tyson has this match in the bag. But Adrian won that match as well. Either way, holy crap, man. Good match. I don't know if it was Natty that was in Tyson's corner 2 weeks ago. Last week on NXT. Where he was stepping it up, but they were definitely stepping it up a lot faster than they were here. But now Tyson has Adrian in that heart lock, or they call it the Dungeon Family Lock or some shit like that. I don't know. But he got him. Oh, swinging neck breaker. Is this enough? Is this enough? 1, 2, 3. Tyson Kidd beats Adrian Neville like he was his fucking bitch or something. That swinging neck breaker got him. I should have put it on slow so it could have got a little momentum going, but either way, good match. Simple and quick. Puts the time back, actually, because, you know, my next match could have gone forever. Because the next match is a triple threat between Kofi Kingston, Psychosis, and Scott Mercury. And who the hell knows how long that match can go on? Me and triple threat matches can go on forever, so we'll find out. But this match is quick and easy, and Tyson Kidd got the victory. So triple threat match up next. Feels good. Being on NXT feels fresh. Either way, triple threat up next. Let's get to it. Alright, I was trying to push my boy Scott Mercury up here, so let's see if he can win this triple threat. He's a master of triple threats right now. He hasn't lost any that I know of in the last 3 weeks. So let's see if he can keep up for 4 weeks. He hasn't been in triple threats every week, but damn near, I think he's undefeated as well, him and Tamina, so good shit, man, good shit. I'm just trying to throw shit in the ring and they just keep kicking it out with their freaking heads. Anyway, Scott Mercury, a new kid to NXT. Kofi Kingston, we all know who Kofi Kingston is. Always active, always explosive, high-flying Kofi Kingston. And then we have a legend in Psychosis. Everyone who doesn't know Psychosis, you might want to go look him up on the interwebs. He was one of the guys. Oh, my gosh, he caught all of that. He was one of the guys that was in. Oh! One of the guys that were in WCW, AAA, all that. All the, you know, Hispanic, very Lucha Libre style wrestling. Him and Rey Mysterio going back at it in ECW. You know, just good times, good stuff going on. One of the masked legends in wrestling. You know what I mean? You look up high flyers in wrestling who are really, really good, and he's definitely high on the list. Oh, did you see that interception? Fucking sick. But, yeah. Definitely a big time player. Oh, did you hear Kofi's head bounce off that? He's backflip and then dropkick. That was cool. Am I missing this? You know what I miss in the old wrestling games? where you were able to... Anyway, you were able to... It was an old wrestling game. I think it was Just Bring It. Yeah, Just Bring It was it. And you were able to go places, and if there was a chairs around, you could set them up. Like, you could set them up to, for sitting, and you could sit down in the chair and sit and watch a match or whatever, and just make it, like, it was really cool. Like, little dumb shit like that. And it was like, oh, that's so sick. Like, me and my cousin, we'd play that shit all the fucking time. We'd just sit down in chairs while other people fight. It was so cool, man. Good time. So, if anyone wants to know where I'm heading with Scott Mercury right now, if anyone's really paying attention, I'm trying to have him go for more of a Tyler Breeze look now. I had him set up for some crazy shit, but I was like, you know, I can only do so much in this game. Let me tone it down. You know what I mean? I wanted to be in a tag team and all that, but I was like, let me tone it down because this is only so much I could fucking do in this game. What the fuck? Okay. Why is it scooting around him like that? Oh. Move that fucking table out of the way. It's like so in the way right now.
Watch out. There's the ladder in the ring now. And again, the ladder comes in.
Yeah! Oh! What? Jeez! Oh, jump, no. Kofi, jump! Oh, don't. Like Kofi, that, don't.
If he has something in his eye. Nice dodge there.
You ain't getting me no fucking...
A textbook reversal. Can he follow up? Oh, back to the head. Back to the...
What the way, referee? My Rock gosh, you are annoying. Oh, he bounced right off that.
Oh.
Oh, what?
Look at this. What is keeping this competitor going?
I almost lost that match if Kofi didn't kick out. So this game wants to be dumb as hell sometimes, bro. Oof.
You can practically feel the wear and tear that's been done throughout this.
Watch. Yeah. What? Oh, where the hell did that come from? He doesn't even have that move in his arsenal. I gotta watch that closest. He'll fucking pull a fucking... pull shit out of a fucking hat and dump it on you. Oh.
And we're going back between the ropes.
And Pela. Beauty mark.
Oh, jeez.
Ah. Over the pin.
He thinks he has it.
Got him. Going for a fucking quick matches here tonight, boy. Quick matches.
Let's check him out. Let's go to the highlights here.
He got him, man. Got him. Got him. Got him. Got him. Got him.
Here is your winner, Scott Mercury.
Why is that ladder in the...
Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
And the future is now. Can't wait till another goes down. And I'm here right now.
Good shit, man. Good shit, good shit. Anyway, next matchup is our first rivalry match of the fucking year. I don't even remember who it is. It should be, hopefully if anything doesn't change up, it should be Nikki Bella. No, shit, sorry. Brie Bella versus Natalya. Anyway, that match is up next, only on NXT. Alright, let's get this match started. Everyone's loving Natalya's attire because I fucking am. I love that I came with that shit. But
twin magic. A battle of wills now. Tell us your thoughts on Natalya here.
Well, you know these two ladies absolutely can't stand each other.
Jeez, I'm getting thrown around by Brie and shit.
I don't expect this one to be pretty at all.
Good shit, Bree. Oh. Anyway, it's funny. It really is fucking funny. There was a time that you couldn't even tell which fucking Bella was a Bella. You know what I mean? You couldn't tell which twin was a twin. There was a time where they really looked alike. And it was like only 2 years ago or something like that. Maybe three. When Beth was there and Kelly was there. There was a time where they looked exactly alike. It was crazy. I was like, which one's which? I couldn't tell which one's which. Had the same gear and everything. It was fucking insane.
At the same time, Breeze made sure she can knock out any diva with that finishing move.
And now you can kind of tell which Bella's which. Fucking Bree, the one in this match right now, looks a lot skinnier. Looks more, you know, anorexic looking. Even though I love the Bellas, and I don't want to talk shit about them. But hey, she looks like she's sick, like something happened to her. She isn't eating or something. I don't know. Still love her. But, yeah, Bree's fucking weird, man. And then, you think she's weird. Her fucking sister, Nikki, you could tell which one she is. She's the thicker looking one with the, you know, the boob enhancement, the more she has more, you know, behind on her and shit like that. She looks thicker, and it's like, oh, now you can kind of tell which one's which, and it's not fun to watch the Bellas anymore as much as they used to be, because there's no twin magic in here anymore. Like, oh yeah, the Bella twins. It's like, no, there's no Bella twins magic at all here. It's just, yeah, put that sign down. This is fucking wrong. Oh, shit. Whoa. Fucking German.
Oh, look at the emotion.
Oh, shit. So, yeah, this is Bella's, man. It's crazy. It really is. Wrestling is all over the fucking place. I like Nikki's gear.
Bree Bella's athleticism, high flying abilities, and
a lot. I hope we keep it in the next game too, because it's so cool.
Italian and Latin heritage, so you can bet that when she gets fired up.
What the fuck is this? Oh my
gosh.
What the fuck? T-bone suplex.
Natalya looking to, and she kicks out at two.
Two. I was like, what the hell is that? I didn't know what she was going for a second.
Look out!
Oh, shit! Wow. Oh! Rope break. The only thing that saved Nikki, I mean, Bree here, I keep saying Nikki. Even though I know which one's which now. It says it on the screen.
Going to the top, high risk.
No, I shouldn't have done that. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? Natalya, you're going to take like 5 years getting to the top rope. I think Big Show will go up there faster than you, girl. God damn, tight or not. Oh, oh!
Watch it!
Oh, shit!
I don't know how much more of this kind of damage she can take.
I don't know if fucking Natalya, both of Natalya's moves were sharpshooters. I hope not. He's tossing on her fucking neck.
Into the ring now.
Oh shit.
And there's the reversal.
Oh shit.
That's a shot that could drop a grizzly.
What the fuck? Oh. Oh no. Jeez. Oh, wow. Animations look stiff at the end sometimes. Like they just don't know where the fuck they're at. It's like, okay.
You know, it's important to point out that Bree Bella has all the right moves. And come on, Cole, I'm talking about in the ring. Can you be professional, please? We've seen Bree create one of the most versatile and effective assaults in the Divas division. Natalya sees the opening.
Natalya sees the opening, all right. Bang.
Natalya sees the opening.
Going for that sharpshooter. It's over. It's over. It's over. I want to see her climb and grab the rope. Rope break.
What's going to happen now?
I'm scared to ask.
Ha!
Oh, did she take a shot there?
Oh.
And what a reversal from Brie Bella. Oh, no. Brie Bella's still dazed.
Come on, Natalya.
Natalya attacking.
Oh, my gosh. Natty, what are you doing? Hurry up. Get the top rope, girl. Damn.
Whoa.
Yeah. Whoa!
And what a reversal.
Holy shit. I was not expecting that at all.
Natalya not letting up.
I don't know what she was going for, but it ain't good. Let's try that again, huh? I don't think going to the well a second time is going to help my fucking cause at all, but fuck it, whatever, right? Oh, jeez. Does she have any signatures or something? Like, I don't know. I haven't practiced out Natalya or anyone's moveset.
Oh!
Natty by nature! It's a squash. It seriously is a squash match. What the fuck? Okay, that's not a move I know. Oh. Oh my god, that looks fucked up! That's a fucked up looking move! What is that? I almost said catamulation, but that looks like a pin-up strong. Yeah, that's a pin-up strong. Pin-up strong. Definitely pin-up strong. Oh my gosh, nothing but submissions from Natty right now.
She might have no choice but to tap. Can she do it? Can she work her way out of this hole?
No! No!
What diabolical things are going
You gotta give Brie fucking
right
credit.
Now.
She is staying in this one.
Oh shit! At your opponent, and that could be what we're seeing here. Great reversal. Brie's in trouble.
I'm not sure what she was gonna go for there. Uh-oh.
And Brie comes up with a vicious counter.
Oh, shit. What are you doing? Brie, cut it out. No!
What a move! What a smart move!
Nope! Pin up strong! I mean, when I call it pin up strong, it's not pin up strong. I'm an idiot. Damn. I don't even know. I don't really know what to do with her right now. I don't know what to do with her at all.
Perhaps going for the sharpshooter again, and she is.
Yeah, Natty got it! She tapped out! Ding, ding, ding!
And that's the match.
I mean, it was simply a squash match. Let's not act like it wasn't.
And
holy
just
shit.
Some of the action we saw during the match.
She just killed her. I think it's Brie's debut match, too. I'm not sure, but goddamn, she got squashed in her debut. Like, it doesn't matter.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. Tamina. Uh-oh. Why is Natalya's eyes glitching now? You see that fucking shit, dude? That's so weird. Anyway, it doesn't even matter. Because... now we got a feud going between Natalya and Tamina. Hell yeah. Our next feud up, Mysterio versus Barrett. Let's see what the fuck happens. Up next. Alright, bad news. Barrett versus Mysterio. Last time we saw these two. Whoa, I've never seen the reversal by Mysterio. That's cool as fuck.
To give an inch in this.
So anyway, last time we saw these two go at it,
bad news, Barrett making a move.
I gotta remember I'm on the other side. Mysterio, no. Fucking, what is it? Damn, hold on. Let me get out of this fucking thing first, because I cannot think to fucking save my life right now.
He anticipated that move perfectly.
Oh, shit.
What?
What the fuck? Barrett just walked out on this motherfucker.
Well, what do you do here?
I don't know, but we're about to find out.
Don't come out here, Mysterio. You might want to stay inside, motherfucker. Anyway, last time we saw Barrett versus Mysterio, Barrett interfered in Barrett's match. Barrett interfered in Mysterio's match, sorry. And
Batista nearly decapitated Mysterio
punchline after a match at the 2009 Bragging Rights pay-per-view. Batista snapped and became fixated on Indy Gray's career.
What the fuck does this have to do with Mysterio? Anyway, so, damn, I can't see, I can't focus. Fucking Mysterio's pissing me off. Anyway, Barrett interfered in Mysterio's match. I think that was week one, where Mysterio was taking on Scott Mercury. He interfered in the match early on, hurt Rey Mysterio a lot, and then Mysterio wanted revenge the next week. Mysterio beat Barrett. And now here we are, 2 weeks later? Yeah, 2 weeks later. We're here. And holy shit.
And he wants to get out of there in the worst way.
Oh! Tell me the referee didn't see that.
Barrett showing a bit of his ego here, but the fact of the matter is he can back it up.
Wait, Barrett. I kind of wanted Barrett to just, like, not just leave the match, but there's always other opportunities for matches like that to happen where, you know, just walk out or whatever. It won't be, I'm pretty sure this won't be the last time this happens in a rivalry match. Maybe next time I'll walk out. Depends how I'm feeling on the wrestler, though. Jeez, fucking my legs are gone, Mysterio. I don't know why going after the legs affects a match like this, because Mysterio's not a fucking limb targeter. He's not a Wade Barrett or a Chris Hero or a fucking, you know, R.I.P. Benoit. He's not one of the, a technical wrestler. He's not a Bret Hart. He's not a Shawn Michaels who's technical and goes after limbs and shit. So I don't know why they gave him that, but I guess it's just to make him, to trip him, you know what I mean? Because what other moves would you give him? Oh my gosh. Fucking big boot to the face. Big time Yakuza kick. What the hell is Barrett doing here, boy? Oh my gosh. Pump handle. Pump handle slam! Out of fucking nowhere.
Yeah, a little intimidation there.
I love how Mysterio has more gauge than me. Well, had.
Wade Barrett showing signs of life.
He's just beating the hell out of Mysterio here. The crowd is not loving it. Speaking of crowds not loving things, if anyone saw that Royal Rumble, holy shit, that fucking Philadelphia crowd is crazy. Philly crowd is on some good shit. But I'll talk about that in ECW, because it has more wrestlers in there that was featured in the Rumble. So.
Make a mistake. If that happens, he's right back in this thing.
No! Mysterio's really bringing it right now. He's reversing all my shit. This time I was reversing this shit. Maybe Mysterio didn't expect it for me to come back in the match. Because he definitely would have stayed out in the ring, which is cool. He would have played to the story. He would have stayed in the ring while Barrett just gets counted out.
Fighter from Manchester. Oh my gosh!
The fuck?
Oh, this isn't over yet. Look at him go.
Come on, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Oh my gosh.
Ah.
Oh no.
Ah. Whoa. No. Mysterio's bringing it to my neck. Oh.
Mysterio has made up his mind to get to work right now. I don't know if there's a superstar more closely associated with a signature finishing move than Rey.
Oh my gosh! Oh,
Rey Mysterio! What a crafty maneuver!
Shit! I couldn't fucking gauge it. I don't know why. I probably was so fucking hyped up that I fucking couldn't get out of it. Oh, that pisses me off a lot. That's annoying as fuck. If, like, you have to understand that's annoying as hell. Make sure like that happens. Someone for me, like, especially when I had things planned out, kind of. Like, I don't have everything planned out, but when things like that don't go, it's like, oh man. Anyway, next up, main event is, fuck, who is it? Blah, 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 blah. Can't think. It is Sami Zayn versus Daniel Bryan. Let's get with it. Main event up next, only on NXT.
Just listen. listen to the chants from this sellout crowd for Daniel Bryan. Sometimes I don't know if they love him or hate him.
Daniel Bryan going for it. Here we go with Daniel Bryan. Sami Zayn's skills aside, what do you think his next move should be?
Well, look, these guys are buddies, you know. They ride to the shows together, they go to dinner together. But unfortunately, being a champion isn't about friendships. He's going to have to put that out of his mind right now if he hopes to win.
I know I haven't talked, and that's because I'm, like, just listening. Because you don't really hear this shit every day with the commentary, I mean. So it's new for me, at least.
And that one hurt his hand.
Out of the way.
You beat yourself like that. But, yeah, Sammy versus Daniel Bryan. His matches happened before in the past, Ring of Honor, stuff like that. So, these guys definitely know each other. Which is fucking amazing. Oh, he didn't even mean it. I didn't mean to kick him like that. But, yeah, last week on NXT, with a way. Fucking referee.
And there's the reversal.
So anyway, last week on NXT, Daniel Bryan defeated Sami Zayn in a tables match with a simple enziguri to the head, and he fell right to the table. I was so pissed off at that match. I was like, are you serious? Matches end like this now? Like, the physics are too babyish at times. But at other times, the fucking tables are fucking Japanese tables and shit. So, if anyone doesn't know the meme of Japanese tables in wrestling, Japanese tables do not fucking break in wrestling. You can put the fucking heaviest guy on it, throw another heavy guy on it, and the table would just stay up there. Which means the quality of the table is great, but not for wrestling matches, where people need to go through things, like tables. So, oh, I thought he was going to do a springboard. I guess not. I don't even know if Sammy does springboards in this game. I'll just find out in a second. Oh! Yes, he does. What the f***? Right now, Sammy is beating the hell out of Daniel Bryan.
You can feel it. Daniel Bryan's all business here.
Look at this gut buster here. Oh, called it before it even happened.
Ooh. Daniel Bryan driven to the mat hard.
Yeah, Daniel Bryan looked mystified by that attack.
And he touches
calf kick, reversed it.
Oh, Sami Zayn going in. For the first time tonight, Sami Zayn wants to fly.
Sami Zayn going up high, boy. Let's go.
Oh, man. A big time miss.
Ow. Jeez. Reversed. Called it.
Whoa,
you can see the way he picked him up. That it was just a reversal. Oh, nice drop kick, Sami.
I don't know if I'd say that's unorthodox as much as it is innovative.
Let's go. Sammy, I think, grabs a little faster than Daniel Bryan. But then again, Daniel Bryan grabbed a little too early as well. Like, he went in too early. So the farther away you are, the slower you grab. Once you close in, you grab a little faster. So let's not have a fucking repeat of what just happened in the last match here. Come on, reverse or something. Oh, no, he's not even going to go for it. He doesn't have enough momentum. I mean, he doesn't have enough time. By the time he gets me to the fucking corner, it's over.
Great reversal.
Called it.
He does it again. And that one hit with the force of a big rig.
Let's try this again, huh? Huh? All right, Sammy, let's do this. Or not. Hey.
He gets out of trouble there.
He ran right into that kick. I'm not even trying to, like, spam him with kicks, but not much else I can do. Oh, what the hell is this? Oh, shit. Don't want a DB to get his momentum up, but by the time he does, be damn near over because unless he reverses it somehow, some way, shit ain't going on. Oh. Here we go. Back and forth. Back and forth. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. I'm loving it right now. I gotta watch out for my arms, because if he gets that cattle mutilation, then I could fucking tap out in a second knowing this game.
Oh.
Move the way. Referee, move the fuck out of the way, dude. He's so in the way for no reason.
Turning it around. It's Sami Zayn with the reversal.
Oh, shit. Fucking reversal fest over here. Calf kick.
What's this?
I want to hit my move of fucking, and then damn, if anyone can know, damn, Brian's face is glitching out like the fucking asshole right now. I want to hit my move, but damn, like, he keeps getting up.
Sami Zayn a second time.
Come on, Sammy. Let's go, motherfucker.
Oh no! Misjudge that.
Okay. Yeah.
Trying to put him away.
Pin.
Sami Zayn smashes that.
One, two,
and he manages to get the shoulder up. Down goes Daniel Bryan. Oh man, come on, Bryan, get up!
I don't know, the taunts be taking away your fucking, you know, doesn't let you restore your stamina while you're up there. Oh shit.
Oh no. Sami Zayn is in deep trouble. I mean real deep.
Go watch those arms, Sammy. Gotta watch those arms. Whew. Move the fucking way, ref. Jeez.
Sami Zayn has eyes to finish.
Yeah, get the fuck out. You glitched ass face. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that shit. Look at that shit. Look at that shit. Fuck out of here. Here we go. 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 Yeah.
Hey! That's gotta feel like being in a car crash. And he gets back in, doing whatever it takes to win. Boy,
oh my gosh!
Take a chance like that. Do you know how badly he must want to win this? And he gets back in the ring. Oh, his body has to be broken right now.
Away!
Just trying to goad his opponent into making a mistake here. Three. Woo, a little showboating going on here.
He's taunting him up.
Back into the ring now. And he gets out of the way. Oh, out of nowhere.
Oh, shit. Here comes Reversal Fest.
Oh, man. Reversal.
Got him.
Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one.
That's totally a Sami Zayn taunt, even though it's just old as fuck. Whoa! Nice roll there, Hax.
Whoa.
Come on, come on, come on. Oh shit, I didn't even fucking reverse that. I was just sitting there watching, because I'm really loving these two right now. Like, I hope they have a good feud right into this.
That one. Leapfrog.
Oh. DB showing off, bro. Swatted that shit like a fucking fly. Oh, shit. German suplex. Ho-ho. What the fuck?
Oh, man, there we go. Jaw-jacking drop kick. Sami Zayn sees the chance to go aerial.
Under the sea. Oh. Oh, shit. DB back in the game, son. Just like that. Just like that. Am I dead? What the fuck is going on with me? Oh.
Two. And he gets escorted back through the ropes.
The fuck? Okay. Ugh. Come on, glitch face. Let's do this.
Now back to the ring. Oh, look at the emotion.
Oh, tilt to a back breaker. Come on. Yeah. I gotta get my taunt up. Come on.
His chances here. Look out! Look out! Oh my gosh! Jumped right on the back of the head.
Motherfucker is still up. Are you kidding me?
Oh, nice.
Oh! Shit! This match is insane. I mean, I'm giving him a little fucking leeway, but it's not. I mean, it's not that much where he can't, like. I wasn't expecting him to do this much work. He punched me in the fucking face.
He anticipated that move perfectly.
I'm trying to get him for the damn Haluva, and he doesn't want to go. Oh my gosh! Suplex back into the ring.
And delivers a lot of impact.
Haluva kick. He said uppercut. God damn, King, you are dumb as hell, boy. Anyway, here we go. One, two, three. Oh, my God. He kicked out. I didn't press anything. He kicked out on his own. Holy shit. I will not lie to you guys. That did not. Usually, sometimes I press R1 to do it, make the match give a little oomph, but he kicked out on his own.
This could do it. Two.
DB don't want to give up.
There.
Neither
this
does Sammy.
Test
here. Whoa.
He may get the three.
No.
Right,
hey.
One, two, three.
See, that time I pressed R1. That just made it look fucking better. It just made it look so cool. Fucking main event status shit right here, boy.
Nice reversal by Brian. Yeah, that's where Brian's quickness really.
Kick me in the arm? What the fuck? What are you doing, DB? What are you doing?
Whoa.
Oh.
His eyes open. Oh, going to the top. High risk. He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now.
Yeah. Oh. Got him. One, two, two.
Ooh, a little showboating.
Yo, I could lose this match in a fucking second. He has a fucking another signature too. Jeez, momentum's out the fucking chain right now.
Oh man,
no, you ain't, son. Oh my gosh, he's still going. I was not expecting this match going this long. At the same time, I'm hitting the 1 hour mark where I'm trying to keep it, you know, 50 minutes max. This shit is starting to get hectic. And this is why I fucking love wrestling, and I love wrestling games, because shit like this. This is the fucking basic shit that everyone should be fucking playing on. One-on-one matches, high momentum, slow fucking momentum gain, and just... Oh my gosh. Only a one. This shows the fucking heart of Sami Zayn, bro. Oh.
And the offensive display by Sami Zayn.
Come on.
This match has taken.
Yeah.
Oh.
Move off the top rope. One, two. Why did the referee come down that third so fast?
Boy, he was able to reverse. Get out of
there. Hey, sunset flip. One, two. Oh, Koji clutch! He got him in the Koji! He tapped. Holy shit, what a match.
Your winner, folks, Sami Zayn. And here's just some of the action we saw during the match.
Let's go! Holy shit. Referee be in the way too much, dude. I didn't want it to be a squash match, but then Daniel Bryan did put a fucking show on, dude. I really wish he hit a couple of signatures, but it was... He doesn't grab fast enough that it can, like, surprise me. Either way, fucking awesome, man. Really good match.
Those WWE competitors tore this arena apart. Let's take a look back on some of the incredible highlights. You have to like this display.
After what these two just went through,
hell yeah, man.
Tremendous amount of respect for
it's like
other.
DB's fucking eye is bubbled shut or something, like swollen. Doesn't matter. Either way, good match between those two. Good matches all together tonight. Fucking loved it. Holy shit. I almost made it to like exactly 1 hour, but you know, a couple seconds, but it's no big. Anyway, as always, guys, comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys on NXT. ECW. Love NXT tonight. They definitely just changed the whole game around. Peace out. Good shit.